Hello and welcome to our digital technology live stream, our final broadcast during COP26, live from our Sustainable Evolution Showcase. My name's Amy Fraser and I'll be your host today. So on this stream, we're going to be talking about our surveying technology, drones, machine control, and our latest venture into plant operator training are all helping us to reduce our carbon emissions. So I'm going to be speaking with our very own digital expert, Mark Crawford, today. Mark, are you able to give me a brief introduction to yourself and your role within Balfour Beatty?
Hi Amy, I'm Mark Crawford. I'm the Digital Plant Manager working for Balfour Beatty Plant and Fleet Services. I've been with Balfour Beatty now for about 2 years, mainly working on developing and introducing the survey reality capture, drone operations and machine control into our business on a daily basis.
Excellent. And what does digital technology look like to Balfour Beatty?
Digital technology for us takes many forms. Where you look at the survey reality capture and the remote drone operations, that means we can start to look at higher quality data, less time on the ground. Whether you start to look at the plant operational telematics for traditional plant and equipment machinery, which means we can start to look at operating time, idle, fuel usage, CO2 emissions. We then get into the data and the software analytics. So we aggregate the data, whether it's reality capture or plant related. We bring it together and we look at how we can do the AI element of looking at predictive works, how we can improve processes around site. And really bringing it together so that we can go from, we can move towards proactive planning on our job sites instead of reactive management. Digital technology for us primarily is about bringing all that data together into an environment, and it allows us to bring the right amount of data at the right rate of requirement to our projects, so that we're always working with the latest information available.
Excellent. And what offering does Balfour Beatty have today?
I mean, you can see in front of us here, we've got a range of survey reality capture, whether it's the latest in scanning technology, whether we look at total stations for your standard topographical surveys or around our drones. We now look at remote drone surveys. We've also got machine control, so we take the survey from a standard instrument onto a machine. I think for us, it's about standardizing the type of software and equipment and hardware that we use. By doing that, it allows us to drive a standard. We also align that with our bespoke survey as a service. So we have engineers, we have surveyors on our site, project teams, but we also have a pool of specialist engineers and surveyors that go out and support those projects. It might be a standard topographical survey, it might be a bespoke GPR or remote monitoring project requirement. By giving them the right tools, we drive a minimum standard for adoption. We can then always make sure that the data is right, is accurate, and actually what we then do is we bring it into the Balfour Beatty ecosystem so that we capture it once, we can use it many times. So I might want to use the data for today and say I'm going to take a scan or a measure, but actually what we did a couple of weeks ago, a team of surveyors came up to shots. This was empty, none of this equipment was here. They came out, they did a full site survey, they used a scanner, they used the drone, and they used the total station. So we mapped out the entire compound here. We've then converted that into a machine control file. It's gone into that machine and currently the operator's working on that, cutting embankment steps out using that data. We've collected it once, we can use it again and again and again. Capture once, use multiple times. You start to go beyond that and you look at the plant telematics data. 2020, slightly quiet year for most of us. Actually, we were busier than ever in construction, carrying on. 2020 versus 2021, we saw an increase of 35% more machines across our workforce and our work site. We've got more machines, more people working, more work being done. Typically, you'd expect idle time. You have machines standing around waiting for materials, waiting for delivery. We were able to use plant telematics data to efficiently and effectively manage how our sites were operating. We reduced idle time by 10%. We had those machines working 12% more across those projects, so we're becoming more efficient and smoother with our plant use. You go beyond that and you start to look at machine control. Machine control, by using the survey data, means we can introduce it confidently. We know we've got the right data, we know we've got the right designs, we know we've got the right survey control that everything's based around and ties into. Machine control allows us to reduce material wastage. We increase the accuracy that we're working to. We increase the efficiency. where typically you'd expect anywhere between 20 and 30% reduction of man hours on site through the use of technologies like machine control.
Excellent. And what does this mean for Balfour Beatty's carbon journey?
I think it all ties together. Again, you come back to, we capture once, we use many times. By being involved in our projects from early contractor involvement through the design stage, at tender, at estimation, cost planning, we can actually work out, we can use that data once, always work with the right data or the most accurate or latest up-to-date information. We share that with our design partners, we share it with our supply chain, we share it with our client. Capture once, use many times. By working with our design partners, we provide them with the design or the latest site survey information that they can design off. We don't then come to site, have issues around clash detection, design inaccuracies, and having to do multiple revisits. Fewer journeys, fewer people on site. You share it with our supply chain. We can say to our supply chain, this is our design, this is our project plan, this is how we're going to do it or how we want to do it. We would then work with that supply chain to look at their supply chain demand management. We have the right machines turning up to do the right job. We have the right them turning up at the right time, and it allows them to make sure that they've got the right machine in the right place, turning up to our site and planning that logistics journey out. Again, we don't need as many site surveys. We make sure we're using the right machines, more efficient operations. You get into our client, and there was a live stream last week with our innovation hub with the team at Hamilton. Actually, for us, a lot of it is about surfacing all the information we're collecting here today or working with, whether it's site progress, site surveys. We visualize that and feed it into that innovation hub. It gives our clients either a bespoke view of their project, we can give them a full regional view, or actually we can share with the executives and senior clients and our next prospective clients about what we do as a business all the way around. You bring it all together, and it's simply about there's less time on site, there's less journeys, there's less need to be boots on the ground and working and becoming more efficient. You then move into the connected autonomous plant environment in terms of where the technology is taking us. Today, we've got an operator in the cab. He's still working to a design, but actually, connected autonomous plant using the right survey, the right design, and the right information starts to bring together the visions of tomorrow are actually realities for today. We aren't that far away from seeing remotely operated plant where an operator can be sat in a cabin and then starting to control multiple machines across different sites. We also have our operator skills hub where it's a well-documented shortage, well-documented in the industry, there is a shortage of resource, of labor, of operators. We bring those operators into our skills hub. We introduce them to the technology. We go through the theory. We go through simulator training. So again, what we don't have is people learning on a machine, that idle time, again, reducing it down. We have everybody together. We take them through it. We then put them through almost a finishing school on the machine. For us, that's about introducing new people and the next generation of workers, of operators and labourers into the market. But for us, it's also about upskilling our existing resource. There's none of this job displacement and replacing people with machinery and technology. Actually, it's still a skilled environment. And by doing so, we introduce those people and we upskill and we retain our staff, and we look to do that through continuous development and training.
Good. And what's coming next then?
Where to start? For us, obviously, we're at a sustainable showcase event. We've got all of our supply chain here together with us over the last couple of weeks. The alternative fueling, the alternative power sourcing is hot debate. However, the data's here and it's available today. By establishing those data connections now, actually, we can get to start to look at the information. We can start to plan. We can start to understand, actually, what equipment will we need in the future? How do we work with people in the future, and what's important to us in terms of where we see true value? The Balfour Beatty have a much wider digital strategy that's aligned to the Innovation 2050 white paper that was published. We really call out a workerless sort of construction site. Actually, the foundations and the base of all of that is all around the data connectivity. If we don't have the data to understand what we do and how we do it today, but then we'll never get to that workless vision site where we're sort of saying, actually, it's all based, going to be around data connections. We work today, we create those connections for the 2050 in the future. What we're starting to see as well, specifically in construction, we're starting to see a lot more of the autonomous plant operations that are already sort of business as usual within mining. They're now starting to surface in construction. The the capability and the technology and the systems and the hardware and software are all starting to establish themselves, whereby we can make the industry far more accessible. We can introduce flexible working, the less downtime in shifts, because actually operators can work from cabins. They don't have to come out into cold, harsh, remote environments where we struggle to get that sort of engagement and support. That data, those data links, allows us to deliver those projects, spending less time on site. We're supporting our communities, our employees, and fundamentally we're supporting the environment. We don't need to have people traveling up and down the country. We don't need to have machines constantly working. We can manage and better support everything that we do, from the early stage of survey collection to all the way through designing our projects and delivering them through construction phases.
Excellent. So thank you very much for joining us today, Mark. I really hope that you've enjoyed our live streams through COP26 and got an insight into what Balfour Beatty are doing to reduce their carbon footprint. So thank you again for listening. And if you would like to watch any of our streams again, they're all going to be available on our YouTube channel.